I think it takes a certain psychological makeup to go into my field. You have to be able to deal with rather unpleasant sights and sounds and maggots.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
Forensic anthropology is a pretty small group of people. There are about 100 of us who have ever been certified by the American Board of Forensic Anthropology. We're physical anthropologists who are specialists in the human skeleton. We work for law enforcement, medical examiners and coroners, the military, human rights work, and for disaster recovery. If I have a completely unknown set of remains, I can tell if it's human or non-human. If it's non-human, sometimes I can tell you what it is, if it's a primate, or it's a dog, or it's a pig, or it's grandma's chicken dinner. I can give you what's called the biological profile, the gender, the racial background, the height, the age. In the mid-90s, I had worked on a serial murder case. It had some very interesting elements to it, elements of dismemberment, which were unique. So I thought, well, that would make the good basis for a story. I had no idea how to write a novel. I'd never done that before. And I told myself, if I get 50 reject slips, I will take that as a commentary on my writing skills. I never dreamed it would go directly onto the top 10 on the New York Times bestseller list. And that, to me, was just overwhelming and incredibly gratifying. I use a core idea from each case. I'm almost fanatic about keeping the science accurate in the books. But I change the names and the dates and all of the details. And then I ask myself, what if this or what if that? And then I spin it off into fiction. And that's what I did with what came to be Deja Dead, my first Temperance Brennan novel.
How did you feel when they started making a TV series based on your books?
My initial expectations were kind of like my initial expectations when I wrote the first novel. Hopefully that pilot will be picked up, and then hopefully we'll get a second season, then on and on and on. And we're now, of course, finishing our 11th and going into our 12th season. We try to keep the anthropology science legitimate.
Looks like resorption. What could have caused that?
A cyst. The victim had de Crevin's tenosynovitis, a painful condition caused by extreme stress on the wrist.
Sometimes we push it to the absolute edge of plausibility, but we do not use techniques that really don't exist, or we don't manufacture anything up. With technology like the Angelotron, which exists, it's a three-dimensional holographic reconstruction apparatus or something, but can you do everything with it that Angela does? She's pretty darn good with that thing.
How are you and TV Temperance similar?
Oh gosh, and a lot of course, what we do. She's a red wine drinker, and I am also a red wine drinker. Temperance Brennan is a mother, and I have three kids. And Temperance Brennan writes novels in her spare time, and I write novels in my spare time. I don't carry a gun. I don't want to carry a gun, but she was really enthused about carrying a gun.
Yeah, take that, you dirty rat!
She also goes a lot more out into the field.
Do any of you recognize this man?
She gets much more involved in the policing end of things than a forensic anthropologist really would do. She's also been known to punch people out. I don't really do that. I'm not a violent person.